சோ மலகிரிலிங்கப்பா அசிஸ்டன்ட் ப்ரொஃபெசர் கவர்மெண்ட் பாஸ்ட் கேட் காலேஜ் சிறுகுப்பா. டுடேஸ் மை சாப்டர் இஸ் ஆல்டர்னேட்டிங் கரண்ட்ஸ் ரவிச் டிட்டர்மினேஷன் ஆஃப் எல் பை ஆண்டர்சன்ஸ் பிட்ச் டிட்டர்மினேஷன் ஆஃப் செல்ஃப் இண்டக்டன்ஸ் ஆஃப் எ காயில் பை யூசிங் ஆண்டர்சன்ஸ் பிட்ச். So determination of L by Anderson's bridge, it is one of the most accurate bridge commonly used for the measurement of self-inductance. There are four resistors. They are connected in the form of quadrilateral R1, R2. R3 and R4. So further the capacitor is connected between A and C. Then a variable resistance, say a small R, is connected between B and D along with A and 4H. An inductor of inductance L is connected in series with the resistance R4 in the arm DC. Then further the whole combination is connected with the AC source. Let I be the main current drawn from the source. At point A, which splits up into two branch currents, I1 along AB and I2 along AD. Further at point B, which splits up into two branch currents. So, where at point A, the main current is splits up into three branch currents I1, I2 and I3. Then at point B, where I1 plus I2 is the current meeting at point B, and I1 plus I2 is the current leaving the junction B, which flows along BC. Then I3 is the current flows through the arm DE, that means through R4, just as shown in the diagram. If a steady balance is obtained in a galvanometer, at a balanced condition, we know that according to the principle of Wheatstone's network, that means the condition for Wheatstone's network, based on that, R1 by R2 is equal to R3 by R4 plus RL, and this is equation number 1. When the current in the head of phone is 0, the bridge is balanced. The potential drop between A and E will be same as that of the between A and D. So therefore I2 by J omega C is equal to I3 R3. Let this is equation number 2. Then I3 is equal to I2 by J omega C R3. At balance, the potential drop along ABC is the same as along ADC. Then by the Kirchhoff's voltage law, we have I1 R1 plus R2 into I1 plus I2, which is equal to I3 into R3 plus R4 plus RL plus J omega L, and this is equation number 3. Then applying KCL to the mesh AEBA, there we get I2 into R plus 1 by J omega C is equal to I1 R1. So I1 is equal to I2 by R1 into R plus 1 by J omega C, and this is equation number 4. I1 is equal to I2 by R1 into r plus 1 by j omega c, equation number 4. Then substituting equation 2 in 3, then we will get I1 r1 plus r2 I1 plus I2, which is equal to I2 by j omega c r 3 into r3 plus r4 plus r2 plus j omega l. Then IL into R1 plus R2 plus I2 R2, which is equal to IL by J omega C R3 into R plus R3 plus RL plus J omega L. Then further IL into R1 plus R2, which is equal to I2 into R3 plus R4 plus RL plus J omega L by J omega C R3 minus R2. Lord, this is equation number 5. Then substituting equation 4 in 5, then we will get I2 by R1 into R plus 1 by J omega C, R1 plus R2 is equal to I2 into R3 plus R4 plus RL plus J omega L by J omega C R3 minus R2. So then further, you know, on both sides I2, I2 get cancel each other. Then 1 by R1 into R plus J, 1 by J omega C into R1 plus R2 is equal to R3 plus R4 plus RL plus J omega L by J omega C R3 minus R2. Let this is equation number 6. 1 plus R2 by R1 into R plus 1 plus R2 by R1 into 1 by J omega C is equal to R3 plus R4 plus RL by J omega C R3 plus 1 plus L by CR cube CR3 minus R2. Let this is equation number 7. Equating the real and imaginary parts, we get 1 plus R2 by R1 into R, which is equal to L by CR3 minus R2. Or L is equal to CR3 into R2 plus 1 plus R2 by R1 into R. Let this is equation number 8. And then 1 plus R2 by R1 into 1 by omega C, which is equal to R3 plus R4 plus RL by omega C R3. Or R2 by R1, which is equal to R4 plus RL by R3. Let this is equation number 9. Comparing the equations 9 and 1, it shows that the combination for AC balance and equation 8 is for AC balance. The inductance balance is obtained by adjusting I and R. In a practice, we have R1 is equal to R2. Then equation 8 and 9 becomes L is equal to CR3 into R2 plus 2R. Let the equation number, 10. RL is equal to R3 minus R4. Thus, L and RL are determined in terms of known quantities. So that means this is the method we have used to determine the self inductance of the given coil by using Anderson's bridge. Thank you.